young people, you just got to understand, it take a long time to make a lot of money. But there's joy in the process, too. You got to be grateful when you're making $50,000. You got to be grateful at $80,000. A lot of people stay pissed off because they ain't a millionaire. If you pissed off where you are right now, you'll never be a millionaire. The more you're grateful for, the more God will give you to be grateful for. Instead of complaining about what's going on. Man, I got to go to work today. Man, I got these kids. Remember when you wanted a job? Remember when you wanted a baby? You know what I learned? You can't cry about what's on your plate when your whole goal was to eat. The moment you start showing God more gratitude, he'll give you more stuff. What he do is, he not gonna keep giving you stuff if what you got you can't handle already. You kill more blessings by not being grateful. That's the number one blessing blocker, lack of gratitude. That's the number one reason I have what I have, and that's the number one reason why I'm going to get more. Listen to me, y'all. Wake up every day and start being grateful. Don't check your phone first. Wake up every morning and just start thanking him for just your life, your kids, your food, your clothes, your money, your husband. And then immediately after that, you'll have a better day. He start giving you more stuff.
There's this thing people think that, like, I'll be happy when. Once I get like this amazing home, or once I get this relationship or an amount of money, then I'll allow myself some happiness. The problem is the finish line always moves. The other part is people think, well, if I enjoy myself now, I'm gonna lose my drive. The truth is there's no correlation between the two at all, between you feeling complete pain all the time and losing drive. And so really the best example of that would be like if you've ever, you know, if I bite into a great piece of steak, you take that first bite, it's like complete bliss. There's no correlation between how great that tasted and your lack of desire for the next bite. In fact, that bliss causes you to want more of it. It's important that we celebrate our wins, we celebrate our lives, because it causes us to want the next bite. And so for me, I want to live in a state of being grateful and blissful now, not waiting for some future place or date that may never arise. I had a really good friend of mine, I went to lunch and he said, I don't know who this guy is here. And he goes, let me ask you a question. Right now, what are you grateful for? And at the lunch, I said, nothing, brother. There's nothing good in my life right now. As I'm mouthing these words, two people walked in with an older man. Both of them clearly were fighting cancer somehow. Both walked by our table and gave me the warmest smile as a stranger. And he goes, that's pretty freaking pathetic. You can't find anything in your life to be grateful for right now. Because if you can find things to be grateful for in that space, man, is your life going to be rich when there really are external things to be grateful for. And what happens is there's this reticular activating system in our brains. All of a sudden, all these things start to come into my awareness that I'm grateful for. I started to see things to be grateful for.
Choose to be happy in spite of life's challenges. Life changes every day. Sometimes things will be going your way. Sometimes it won't work so well. Sometimes you'll have your health, you're feeling good, and there's some things that can happen to you in life that can take all of that from you. Life always changes. But you can choose in the midst of all of this that's going on to be happy in spite of it. Viktor Frankl, he said, the last of the human freedoms to choose one's attitude in any given set of circumstances, to choose one's own way. Douglas Matlock has a poem I love. He said, sure, this world is full of trouble. Lord, I've had enough and double reason for complaint. Rain and storm have come to fret me. Skies are often gray. But say, ain't it fine today? What's the use of always keeping thinking of the past? Each must have his tribulation, water with his wine. Trouble? I've had mine, but today is fine. It may rain again tomorrow. It may rain, but say, ain't it fine today? Ain't it fine today? Living in the moment, getting everything we can out of where we are in the moment where we are right now. The other thing is, willingness to let people and things go, especially if they want to go. When they're no longer good for you, just let them go. Just to hold on tenaciously really doesn't make really good sense, all right? Next thing is face the truth about life and deal with it in order to have a fulfilling life, knowing that things are going to happen. Expect the unexpected. Everything that happens, use it for your upliftment. What can I get from this? How did I end up here? What's the blessing in this for me? And don't let it go until you get your blessing out of it, because there's a blessing there. There's something for you in everything that happens to you, for you to learn from that experience. Analyze it, dissect it, take it apart, and then get what you need from that and move on. Here's something I encourage you to do. Whatever you do, do it in a consciousness of love, in spite of the circumstances. Emmett Fox said, love is absolutely invincible. No disease that enough love will not heal. No door that enough love will not open. No wall that enough love will not throw down. It makes no difference how deeply seated may be the trouble, how great the mistake, a sufficient realization of love will dissolve it all. And he ends it in a scripture that says, God is love, and he that dwelleth in love dwelleth in God. But whatever work you have to do, do it lovingly. Just decide to be more loving, more giving, more caring, more sensitive than you've ever been before. But what if... back. But don't count on it. Don't let someone else determine who you're going to be. Do it because that's who you are. Do it because it gives your life a sense of fulfillment and self-respect. Anybody can hate. Anybody can do that. Anybody can hold a grudge. But the real challenge about growth and moving into your greatness, it's about being who you are. I say, as you look at life, as you go toward your goals and your dreams, spring forth with a mighty faith to start the business that ought to be started by you, to make the difference in our society that ought to be made by you. How is it that I can make the contribution that I showed up to give? And one last step, I think, in the area of self-fulfillment, you must live in a spirit of gratitude. There's so many things, ladies and gentlemen, that we take for granted. There are a lot of things that we need to be thankful for. There are big things, there are little things. I'm thankful for my children. I'm thankful for the life that I live, and for the people who have enriched my life.
You can't wait till you receive the promise. You have to thank God that the answer is on the way. Don't talk about how you feel. Say, thank you that I'm healthy. Thank you with long life you're satisfying me. In your finances, maybe you're struggling. All through the day, thank you that whatever I touch prospers and succeeds. Thank you that your favor surrounds me like a shield. When you thank God in advance for the answer. answer, that's what keeps you encouraged. You're not going to stay determined if you're talking about how bad it is. God, you said you wanted me to be blessed, but my business is so slow. No, switch over into praise. Business may be slow, but Lord, I want to thank you that you prosper me even in a desert. Praise makes you strong. Praise keeps you moving forward. I'll thank God after business picks up, after I see the solution. So if you don't learn this principle to thank God in advance, you won't have the strength you need to wait for the promise.